Hi, this is Amy from the Altis store. I want to show you the battery racking system from Outback Power. It's the IBR. What I'm showing you here has got the two shelves, and it's also available with three shelves. So this is really nice because it fits their nice energy cell batteries. So I'm going to show you with their nanocarbon batteries. These are fabulous battery for off-grid situations because with the carbon inside the battery, it actually can handle a partial state of charge a lot better than most other battery technologies. So this is really, really good in case your solar can't regularly charge the battery up all the way. The nanocarbon batteries actually are okay with a partial state of charge, unlike any common lead acid battery. We've got a video that talks more about it, so you can check that video out. But I want to show you the racking system that will hold either 8 or 12 of them, depending on if you're doing two strings or three strings. So again, this is the two strings here. So I want to show you how this all works. It'll take the energy cell batteries. It'll also take any standard 8D size battery. So you can have a nice size battery system with this. So each of these batteries is about 131 pounds or 60 kilograms. So you probably want to have a friend help you with this. But you would slide these into the shelf, and it comes with these terminal bars, the batteries do. So you can simply bolt them together, and this gives you a nice heavy terminal bar as your battery interconnect cable. So you don't have to buy separate cables. Each battery comes with these terminal bars. So we tighten these up. You want to make sure that your terminals are always really nicely tightened. Okay. So another nice thing that these come with are these little protectors. So all you have to do is snap these right in here. So this gives you still access. So if you want to get your voltmeter in here, you can do that and check on things. But it's going to help prevent you from shorting between the batteries, which is very bad. So it gives you a little bit of protection here. So you'll see I've got these wired in series, plus to minus. So I've got 12, 24, 36, 48 volts. And the negative is going off to the negative bus bar, which we'll show you in a minute. And the positive, let's take a look where that positive is going. So because this is a two-shelf model, we're going to have two parallel strings. So that plus comes off the last plus and goes to the breaker. The output of the breaker then goes to this positive bus bar. The same thing happens with the other shelf through a breaker to the positive bus bar. So this is protecting everything, protecting the wires, protecting the other strings. So if something goes wrong with one string, that breaker will trip and you're not going to damage your other string. On the three shelf unit, you would have a third breaker and they would all go down to the common positive bus bar. You then connect your battery to inverter cable and that would then go off to the main breaker for your inverter, which will connect the battery bank to the inverter. Let's pop over to the other side and see what we do with the negatives. So on this side of the string, we've got our negatives from each string going to the negative bus bar. Now, because this is going to be a grounded system, we're breaking just the positive. So the breaker's on the positive, no breaker on the negative, just goes to the negative bus bar. And then that next cable will go up to the negative bus bar in your DC load center to go to the inverter. So that is how you're going to be wiring this all up. So it is nice where everything's got plexi on top, so you've got nice visibility, yet you've got safety from prying fingers. And I'll actually show you that the front actually has it as well. So in addition to these nice little caps you've got for protection, we also have the plexi that goes right on the front here, just bolts right on. So it gives you easy access, but it also gives you the protection from wayward fingers and tools. Now, this is for sealed batteries because this is not a sealed battery cabinet. This is not something that you would vent. It is open in the back. It's kind of open just through the plexi, but it's not something that you would use with flooded batteries where you have to keep all that hydrogen inside. This really is for sealed batteries. And you see you've got the breaker right in the front, each of the breakers. So nice complete system, just under 3 feet high. You do want to put this on a solid surface, because once all of these batteries are in here, it's going to weigh probably over 1,000 pounds. So make sure where you're putting this can support that weight. Just the rack itself is very nice and strong and sturdy. It's about 60 pounds. So it's a really nice, safe, clean setup for your sealed batteries. I hope this was helpful. If so, give us a like and a share. And be sure to subscribe to our AltiStore channel, so we'll notify you when we've got new videos coming out. And don't forget to go to our website at altistore.com, where we've been making renewable doable since 1999.